je hersenen, je hoofd. And we're going to do this talk show in English. I almost forgot. So welcome everybody. I'll start again. My name is Eva van Zeeland. My platform is called Miss Natural Lifestyle, and it's all about awareness and consciousness. So if you're watching right now, please leave a comment to let me know that you're here. My special guest tonight is Christiane van Wijk from Mind the Matrix. And I see that already some people are watching. So if you got some questions, just drop them in the comments and we will come to you. So now I'll bring my guest. She's ready. She's born ready. And there she is. Hello.
Hi.
Hi. I just started in Dutch. Did you hear that?
Yes, I know. Alert you.
Because we're all.
It is a bit strange because we're both Dutch, so.
Yeah, but we want to bring the global awakening to a broader audience, so let's do that. And let's you had it. This vision 2010. You had the ayahuasca experience and this call from the universe or Mother Earth or your inner being. Yeah.
Oh, definitely the inner being. I always do make a disclaimer when I speak of my experience.
Yes.
With regards to ayahuasca, because I do not encourage people to take that, especially because I have the feeling that the ceremonies aren't what they used to be anymore. And I feel that there is a lot of interfering energy in a lot of ceremonies. So I'm definitely not encouraging that. But at the time that I did it, which was 10 years ago, it wasn't very known yet in the West, and you had the occasional ceremonies happening. I felt the call to go. Funny enough, it already started to work before I even drank it, which was really interesting. Yeah, it was just an energy build up, and I already went, whoa, I haven't even had it yet. Ended up having half a cup, and most of the people in the tent that where we were had three cups throughout the night, but for me, half a cup was enough.
Can I just add something? I did ayahuasca once as well, 2 years ago, and I drank one cup, and then they said, yeah, if you want more, we could have three rounds, and you can come back for more, and I hear them in the... But I was so lost. I was so lost. I that wasn't for me as well. I was so lost. But I didn't have that good experience you had. But that's another story.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, these things are always very different depending on what's needed for the individual.
Yeah, that was needed for me. Do you know what I said during your ayahuasca? Everybody, it was just working, and I was lying there. Oh, I was still sitting, and I said, oh, this is boring. I said it was boring. Yeah,
really.
All the sad faces of the cartoons. First they were happy, and then everything turned sad. And and I'm for me, life must be always happy, always in the good vibes. And I felt alone. I felt sad. And but okay. Next story.
So maybe that's you needing to balance yourself out a little bit, acknowledging the. Also the sad little girl inside of you somewhere.
Yeah, that's true,
whatever is needed. However, I'm currently working with a spiritual teacher in Colombia, and he's really adamant that we should be able to walk this process of awakening without any substances. In fact, the substances can become a major contributing factor to afflictions. Mm-hmm. So in a sober state, we should be able to really embark on this awakening process perfectly fine. However, I did have my half a cup, and I was given some really major visions, and I just knew these visions were not just some vision. This is stuff that I had always known in my being, and I knew that I had come here at this time on planet Earth to be part of the shift. And I also understood that whatever it was that I was going to be doing after this experience had to be in alignment with what was going to happen on planet Earth.
Mm-hmm.
Most souls knew when they came here that we were in a very major transitional time on this planet.
Yeah.
A lot of people don't know it in their personality because they're cut off. So they're basically influenced by outside conditions and not influenced by the spirits. If they were connected to their spirit, they would know that there's massive stuff happening on the planet. It's undeniable.
But first we go a little bit back. If you're watching, you have any questions, just drop them and we'll answer them for you. Connection with your own spirit, that's not common for everybody. Did you have that all your life, or was that the turning point for you after that half a cup?
I wasn't consciously aware of it, but I was a very spirited person already from small age onwards, very spirited, very driven by something bigger. Mm-hmm. But I wasn't consciously aware of that. I guess my mom would consider me to have had ADHD in a way. But it was only later that I started to become really conscious of the fact that, hey, I am a spirit. I am not this identity of Christiana.
It's a temporary part.
And really, my consciousness is the eternal part of me. A long time ago, as you know yourself, probably people used to ridicule you and call you all sorts of names when you were talking about spirituality. People were extremely uncomfortable about it. However, now it seems to be that people are like, whoa, I need to know more about this now, because I know that I'm missing out on something. And suddenly we're having this massive global awakening, and the ridicule phase is starting to wither away, and now suddenly it's becoming, you know, a big key subject for people.
Yeah, and then you made this the documentary series that everybody must watch, Mind the Matrix. I can show it in the screen. I have it here. This is, let me see how it can show it to you. It's now below you. So this is the you first made a movie, then the 10 episode documentary. So people can see that, and this is something that you posted on your timeline earlier. Feels like Mother Earth just sent us all to our rooms to think about what we've done. I find that really funny, because it's like we are a bit sent to our rooms, or not.
Yeah, well, in a way, you see, the thing is, whatever we say, it's only one part of the truth. Mm-hmm. And this is what we really need to be aware of right now as humanity, to not get stuck on one version of the truth, because we are missing out on the whole picture. Yes. There is a lot going on right now, a lot. And diving into only one aspect means you only dive into one part of the rabbit hole, and you can get very stuck in there. So it's both a negative as well as a positive thing that is happening right now, and it's up to us to really get clear on what's future scenario we want to focus on.
Yeah, so if you focus on that's the majority you're going to experience in your life, like the shift from the third dimension to the fifth dimension.
Yes, well, I saw that shift in my ayahuasca experience. So when I saw it, I already knew that I had seen it, that I'd known it all my life and before. Mm-hmm. What was very clear is that Earth was going to go through a big transition that at first would seem negative. So there would be an elimination event and quite a lot of people passing away. However, this passing away event of a large part of the of people was called a mass consensual ceremonial death. Mm-hmm. So when I looked at these people going, I saw that they weren't suffering, and I realized that on some level they had chosen to go.
Yes, that's why here in the movie I shared with you today, she's telling the same thing, that people they don't want to go with us to this new dimension. They choose that, and also spirit workers or light workers who they finished their job, they are leaving as well.
Yeah. I mean, it in a way it doesn't actually really matter. We're so focused in our society on keeping ourselves alive, instead of the biggest focus should be for us to be aligned with our spirit. That should be the key focus right now for humanity, because if we are not aligned with our spirit, we don't actually know what's going on around us at the moment, and we'll just follow the masses like a sheep.
Yes.
Right? That's we have to, because we have no information coming in from our eternal spirit that we are. And as a result, we are in absolute fear. We're feeling absolutely lost. And we need to go where the crowds are, because that makes us feel in some way still safe. Mm-hmm. And I really, really want to encourage people that if they get bored right now because they're in lockdown and they can't go anywhere, use this time to get into a relationship with your spirit.
Yeah.
And you can do that by simply inviting the full integrity of your spirit back in. You can actually simply set the intention of doing that. You can say, I invite the full integrity of my spirit. And even setting the intention already sets a whole process in motion. So you don't even have to be learned or have read a lot about it. You don't need to do that. It's a natural thing, right? It's our natural birthright to be living life as a spirit, having a human experience. So just saying that every morning, you know, I invite the full integrity of my spirit will start to change a lot. And you will start to see reality in a completely different way, eventually even seeing through the matrix.
Yes. Yeah. Look behind the curtain.
Open. Yeah.
And
yeah.
Then you get really confused because that are the three stages. I showed them three days.
Yeah, I like what you did.
Worldwide, fear, virus, freak out, and based on fear-based programming. And, oh, they're going to, we have to use apps, and they are in control, and the new normal. And then the 4D is seeking answers, diving into the rabbit hole. The mass disclosure, and then the fifth dimension is opening the heart chakra and activating downloading of the light codes. So but I shift from 3D to 5D, and I'm a bit addicted to the alternative media right now, so I don't watch the mainstream media, but this is happening a lot today, and I'm really exciting and curious what Trump is going to say tonight, because it's Good Friday, the days before Easter. So I think he's going to have some surprises for us. But so I have to make space for my spirit. So I worked in the garden today, like yourself. What do you do more to be grounded and to make connection to yourself?
Well, there's one really simple thing that was given to us, which was nature. And people have really not, you know, they're like, oh, we have to stay in our houses. Well, unfortunately, that means we can't actually connect with the biggest healer of them all, which is nature, because nature is constantly reflecting to us that which is completely real and non-matrix. So just by being with nature, observing nature, you can start going into the same frequency as nature and come back to a natural state, and natural enough for the body to receive the spirit.
Yeah,
because the spirit, you know, it's hard to engage with a human vessel when there is so much noise going on. You know, the food that we eat, the thoughts, the negative thoughts that we have, the EMF radiations, vaccinations that have gone bad, you know, the lot, it's all making for quite an unhealthy environment for our spirit to want to be in, you know. So we have to work on it on multiple levels, you know, be aware of what we eat, be in nature, really become aware of the recurring thoughts that we have all day long.
Yeah. And
a lot of people are on the merry-go-round.
Yeah. You've got the puppets on your shoulder. They're talking to you, the Muppets. So I love that it's springtime, and the daytime, longer daytime, and we've got the sunshine. You just told me you find it strange that there's no rain, but it's really good time of the year. If it was like autumn or winter now, I think everybody would be depressed at this moment. But
totally.
Yeah, but okay. So we really want to give people advice because a lot of people are scared or shifting, want to stay in alignment. So
With the fear, if they feel the fear, if they, you know, if they're on their own and they're feeling this overwhelming fear of not knowing what's to come, feel the fear of boredom, the fear of isolation, the fear of not knowing, you know, it is totally okay to feel these sensations, and I would really encourage people to be really okay with sitting with those feelings, you know, like and lie in your bed a bit longer and just really become aware of these feelings and let them and start exploring them rather than judging them as something that is something that we have to get rid of and yeah. Oh, I need to distract myself right now with something else. You know, we can distract ourselves forever, but at some point we're gonna just have to sit with ourselves, you know?
Yes.
So again, this is an opportunity to do that.
And tell yourself a new story. So if you're telling yourself the old story all the time, then you don't get a new chapter. So tell yourself a new story. What would you like to be or have or experience in your future? So yeah, we are the movie directors ourselves of our lives. So
in make a way we are.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What
yeah,
would absolutely. Be your ideal script for
Oh, that's a good question.
Period.
Well, the thing is, in my vision, I went to the fifth dimension and I went to the future and I was shown what that was going to be like. And it is so different from this current reality that my mind was a little bit, you know, my mind couldn't fathom what I was experiencing.
Okay.
It almost feels like it is all feeling based.
Mm-hmm.
And the mind it has a new role in that dimension. It's very feeling. Yeah. So learning to feel might be a good thing to prepare for this shift, because the mind is not going to cope very well, especially if you are very negatively charged. It's not going to be a very pleasant place to be if you haven't worked with it. So very much, you know, surrendering into the heart space, which is, you know, especially when we're in the Netherlands, we're also rational, you know, and organized. And for us, it's quite hard to surrender into the heart space, you know. Mm-hmm. We joke around it, about it, you know, and we think it's not important, but it's actually of extreme importance to cultivate that part of ourselves.
Yeah.
But you asked me, how do I see? Sorry?
No, I was just thinking about the time I did the Tantric Women's Soul Coach year training, and that was all about going to the feelings, going inside, and get rid of all your layers and get to the. But it was really exhausting, and so most of the people want to avoid that, going to the pain. They numb themselves with food or alcohol or other other things, so you don't have to feel. But now everybody,
we've all done it, and we all do it to an extent.
Yeah. But now it's a good time to.
Sorry, see. I think there was a connection.
Yeah, there was a connection mistake. But now is a good time to see if there are still some hidden issues you have that you can bring to the light, to the surface.
Absolutely, yeah. I'm realizing what we have a delay going on, which is a bit funny.
But you're not in the Netherlands. You're not in Australia anymore.
I know, but I guess everyone's online.
Yeah.
So I don't really have a clear vision yet on what I want to create in this new dimension, because I feel like, and this sounds a bit dramatic, but I feel that my work was all to do with the helping of the awakening. And what I'm super excited about right now is that I see so many people wake up. I did not think it was going to be that big of a movement. It's fantastic. You know, and to those people that haven't woken up yet, I just really want to say.
Oh, and the sound is gone.
Do your goddamn research.
Ah, do your own research. Yes, that's what I say as well. Because a lot of people say, oh, I want proof. Tell me how.
Do your goddamn research. I say.
Oh, sorry. People have to do their own research, I'm saying, because a lot of people ask me, oh, tell me, and where's the proof? And I say, no, you have to research yourself. And that's with everything. I'm not here to tell you what is good or what is bad for you. You have to research yourself. It's time that you take your own responsibility again to claim your own authority.
Yes, absolutely, 100%.
Yeah,
100%. You know, I mean, yeah. Sorry, no, I know we have a delay, so I'm sorry if I'm overlapping what you're saying because there's a delay. But what is absolutely key right now is that you have all these different factions saying this is going on, that's going on, that's going on. It's absolutely vital you stay within your own power and you research for yourself, because that is exactly what the problem is, you know, like most people have some part of the truth, but you have to start doing your own research. And, you know, Robert Jensen was saying, you know, something that I really, really made me laugh is when he said that people say, well, I believe in science, you know, and it's like, well, but why do you believe the scientists? You know, when, you know, there's all sorts of lobbying going on and agendas going on that cannot be trusted. And we should know that by now, that that's the case. And we should know that something is right here.
Yeah, yesterday you said in your live stream that you feel sorry for all the high educated people because they really rely on the scientists.
I can feel sorry for them in some aspects. Absolutely admire, you know, I love, of course, there's nothing greater than someone who has a beautiful mind, you know, that's fantastic. But sometimes I do feel that it can also be a disadvantage for some people in the sense that they want to try to understand everything with the mind when actually the intelligence of the heart and the spirit are superior.
Yeah, you have to kind of combine them. And so if you read something with your mind, then you can think logically, okay, is this correct? And then you must feel with your heart and with your gut, your spirit, does this resonate with me? How does this feel? Do I feel, how do I feel? That's a sign. And that we can trust more.
Yeah, and when we go into fear, we go into that mind. And you know, like, I'm not slagging off the mind at all, just let that be very clear. But it's not the be-all and end-all. It's not everything, you know? There is a lot more, we have a lot more sensors in our being to see what's truth and what's not. And we need to start developing that again, that sense that we all have, to see, like, when are we, you know, being deceived? Mm-hmm. And there's something very, very strange going on here with this virus. And I know that I piss people off when I say it.
No, but it's true. It is. Yeah.
There's obviously, you know.
Bill Gates and even Madonna now supports Bill Gates. Have you seen that today on our timeline?
It's so creepy. Some of these things are so creepy, you know. I mean, again, you know, I'm not saying this is wrong or this is right, but all I'm saying is just do your goddamn research.
No, then
you have to. You have to, because if you don't,
Have you seen the Zimbabwe in Africa? They test all those vaccines, and Bill Gates is all about reproductive health, but that's abortions and also vaccines. Give vaccines because then you become infertile, so you can't have any children anymore, and that. Especially they want that in Africa because they don't want the people to reproduce themselves anymore. So that's the way Bill Gates reduced the population in this world.
Yeah. So can I ask you a question?
And now I'm still happy because I don't let that in. I'm not scared of Bill Gates because Bill Gates is going to kick ass. He's got another pie in his face.
I'd like to ask you a question, Ava.
Yeah.
If that's all right, because some of the Minor Matrix fans have contacted me to ask what do you think that vaccine, that COVID-19 vaccine will have as ingredients, or what do they intend
to do? It will have the disease.
Right.
So if you get the shot, you will get the disease and more. I think there. I believe the story of the nanobots, the micro the particles, I can't speak the word aluminium in English. You can say it for me. But read the ingredients. It's the same story. If you buy your groceries, you read the ingredients. So I recommend you to do the same with the vaccine. And a lot of people they just give their child or their baby, or even when they're pregnant, they just take the vaccine without even looking at the ingredients. They trust the authority, the doctor, but they don't know as well. So please check yourself and do your own research. That's the same for vaccines. And I believe everything in nature is, the animals don't need vaccines. But now I hear even cats get a letter in the mailbox for their new vaccine. My cat, she's 13 years old. She never had a vaccine, and she's also walking outside. So
it's obviously, I can imagine, affecting the immune system as well.
Yeah.
So that they cannot actually, and I've heard somebody say as well that it could affect the whole DNA.
Yeah,
because you have done more research on it.
That's the whole point. They want to make half cyborgs of us. And then we are really trapped in the matrix and we can't reincarnate anymore. Then you're stuck in this virtual reality game, your own head.
I can say positively that from what I saw in my vision is that the bad guys were going to lose. In fact,
yay! Can you say it again? A lot of people are waiting for this answer. Are you sure, 100%?
Well, I can tell you this. So what happens in the vision, what I was shown is we were going from third to fourth to fifth, right? Fourth being a transitional dimension, which is like a thought plane and, a lot of quicker manifestation, and it can be quite scary. Fear is heightened there because you manifest your fears quite quickly in it. But what I saw is that I was taken to all these underground bases, right, in this vision. And there were a lot of them, actually. There were many, many of these underground bases all over the world. I've since heard there are apparently a lot of these bases. Anyway, I traveled with my consciousness to these bases. And in the middle of this massive dimensional shift, the sort of elite that were underneath there couldn't cope with the energy shift. They couldn't cope, and they started annihilating each other.
Oh.
You know, that was like mass suicides and mass, mass eliminations. They couldn't cope with the shift of the frequency. It was not, they weren't, you know, they weren't made for that.
It's important that we stay in the high vibration.
Big time, you know, like, don't deny what's going on, because I also think it's not a good idea to deny. There clearly is stuff going on, you know, and you clearly have to be able to say no to something that you don't want, you know, and I do encourage people to stand up for their rights. Mm-hmm. Absolutely. But do not forget that you are still a creator of, you know, of the reality, and focus on the reality you do want, and it will happen. Yeah, actually.
Soon.
It was very clear. There was no doubt.
I hope very soon. I hope maybe tonight we've got some good. And I think because Q said 10 days of darkness, but maybe the 10 days of darkness, I thought about that today. Maybe that was 10 days in the bunkers, in the undergrounds, that they are cleaning up, 10 days of cleaning up.
But you know what? A lot of these things don't come out, you know, and that's not that they're wrong. It's often really hard to see when things are going to happen, you know, and especially when you get information in the spirit, it's really hard to see when certain things are going to eventuate. That's why I personally never tried to make a date.
Yeah, my psychic also always says, I'm always wrong with time, she says, because time doesn't exist. So that's...
So who knows how long this process is going to be, but just get ready for the ride, because it's going to end up really amazing.
Yeah.
It really is.
And I
really freaking amazing.
Yeah. But it's all about more about the quick manifestation. I already heard about that. That's if you want something, you can have it really quickly. Also, the new forms of energy will be released. A lot of people are going away, and so there will be a new economy, a new banking system. So can you tell me, because we talked about that earlier. The Dutch guy, he was with the Tribunal of Natural Justice. What's his name? He's in your documentary as well.
Ronald Pinaar.
Oh yes.
Ronald
Pinaar. What's he doing now? Do you know that? Do you know what's he doing now at this moment?
I haven't been in contact with him for a while. I think we have a massive delay happening.
Oh, okay. No, I can still hear you. Okay. If you're watching, really nice. It's a Good Friday. Is that Good Friday?
Yeah.
Is that the end of the world? Is that
Sorry, guys.
Do you have a delay? Okay, I'll talk. So if you have got a question for me, just let me know what you're going to do.
Yeah, it is.
Weekend. And if you're going to hide some eggs in your garden, I hope not chocolate eggs, because if they melt, then they will be really soft. And I was going to announce some winners of my e-course, 40 Days Without Sugar. I put that on my timeline. So if you answer that, I will announce the winners later of the 40 Days Without Sugar. And you can start after Easter, because that's a bit like Christmas time. Huh? You have to enjoy yourself. We are not Miss Perfect. Christiane, what are you doing this weekend? You got some special plans with your... you've got some house roommates there where you're living?
Yeah, we're gonna... Yes, we do. And we're gonna make some funny spoof stories. We're gonna film some Percy Flashes.
Ah, cool.
So on the COVID situation.
Ah, oh, that's funny. And you've got a script already?
The delay is really long.
Ah, now we start to wrap it up. I think that's better.
Yeah, yeah. So I just wanna. Can I add one more thing?
Yes, of course.
Yeah, the connection is so bad. I do want to say one thing, Eva, if you can hear me.
Yes, I can hear you.
You can hear me. Okay. So the reason why I made Mind the Matrix, the film and the series, is because I felt it was, you know, the role to to help with the awakening. So I really want to encourage people that want to know what, you know, that want to know what to do, to watch the series, because it takes you through a whole journey in 12 episodes.
Yes, I will share the link below the video so that people can
And looks at all different aspects of where awakening can take place.
I think you're shifting to the third dimension right now.
Wow.
Really gone. It's really bad connection. But I love talking to you, Christiane. I think we have to wrap it up. It's a really slow connection. So I think you're already in the fifth dimension.
Okay.
Okay.
Hang on. I'm just going to get some data, because this is crazy. It's so slow.
We already talked for 34 minutes. So if you're still watching and have a nice question, you can drop it here. Hank says, what's Bennett Glamage? Thank you, Hank, for this great high five. And stay happy and stay in your same place. Watch some comedy movies, or make your own comedy movie, or spoofs, or like Christiane said. So do something funny, or go play outside, draw, dance. Have a nice time. I'll see you next time in the Miss Natural Talk Show. Bye-bye.